गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ अ वीडियो ऑन द टॉपिक इफेक्ट ऑन बॉडी व्हेन टू और मोर फोर्सेस एक्ट ऑन अ बॉडी फ्रॉम द चैप्टर फोर्स एंड प्रेशर. देयर आर थ्री डिफरेंट केसेस ऑफ सच सिनेरियो. द फर्स्ट केस व्हेन टू और मोर फोर्सेस एक्ट इन द सेम डायरेक्शन. द सेकेंड केस व्हेन टू अनइक्वल फोर्सेस एक्ट इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन ऑन अ बॉडी. एंड द थर्ड केस if two equal forces act in opposite direction, if two equal forces are acting in opposite direction. So let's get started. The first case, if an object is there and two different forces F1 and F2 are of different magnitude, suppose F1 is of 10 newton and F2 is of 5 newton, they both are being applied on the body. So what happens after some time? The body moves from position A to position B. You can take a daily life example. Suppose two students are pushing a desk. Both the students are applying different force on the desk. So it becomes easier to push the desk when two or more forces are acting in the same direction. Suppose you add one more student. Then what happens? Three different types of forces are being acting on the same direction. So it becomes easier to push that desk in a particular direction. In this case, F1 and F2 are there. F1 is of 10 newton, F2 is of 5 newton. Two different students applying two different magnitudes of force. One is applying a force of 10 newton and another is applying a force of 5 newton. Then what happens? The resultant force which is being acting on the body, that is Fr, denoted by Fr, equals to F1 plus F2. F1 is 10 newton and F2 is 5 newton. They simply add up and give 15 newton. Therefore, the resultant force which is being acted on the body is equal to 15 newton. The second case, if two unequal forces act in opposite direction, suppose an object is there, two different forces act from opposite direction. Suppose F2 is greater in magnitude, greater in numerical value as compared to F1. F2 is of 15 newton and F1 is of 10 newton. Then what will happen? Idhar se jyada force lagega. What will happen? The body will move in this direction. I have denoted here the direction of motion. F2 is greater than F1. Therefore, the body will start moving in this direction. After some time, the body will move till point B. In this case, the resultant force, that is Fr, is given by F2 minus F1. Since F2 is greater than F1, therefore it is denoted by F2 minus F1. If F1 would be greater than F2, then Fr would be equal to F1 minus F2. Here F2 is 15 newton, F1 is 10 newton, 15 minus 10, that is 5 newton. The resultant force which is being acted on the body is 5 newton and the direction of motion is in this direction. The third case, if two equal forces act in opposite direction, two equal forces are being acted on the body from opposite direction, what will happen? The body will simply not move. If the body is not moving, then Fr would be equal to F1 minus F2. And since F1 and F2 both are equal in magnitude, both are equal in numerical value, that is equal to 10 newton, F1 minus F2 would be equal to 10 minus 10, that is 0 newton. Hence, there will be no movement in the body. The body will not move. Thank you.